Hey, what's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to remove these people or this couple out of my travel photo that I took in France in front of this church right here. Currently, I'm in the Alps, so let's get started. So I'm going to press on the healing brush tool, or you can press Q to get it activated. And I'm going to zoom in on this area here. And right now, I'm on the content-aware healing brush tool, so when I brush over people or an object, Lightroom's going to select the best area to replace it with, or the best pixels to replace it with. So you can change the size of the brush here, or you can press left or right square brackets and keep the opacity at 100. So I'm just going to make it a little bit smaller and then brush over this couple here and make sure I get the middle as well. And let's see how Lightroom does. So it did an okay job here, but let me refresh it. And this actually looks a little bit better. And if I, right now the overlay is off, so if I press H, I could turn the overlay on, and I'm gonna turn it off again just to clean up this a little bit more. So still on the Content Aware tool, I'm gonna brush this area here. There's a little bit of a hard transition here, so I'll clean this up. And this little building or structure here, it's messed up, so that looks a little bit better. Now I'll go to the healing tool. Actually, let me undo that and make sure I escape out of the current tool. Select the healing tool, turn off the overlay. And right now I'm going to clean this up a little bit right here and turn back on the overlay. And I'm going to see what Lightroom selected as the replacement area. Selected this, so I'm going to select a better area. And actually increase the feather to make the transition a lot more soft. And let's see here, move this up a bit. So that looks a little bit better now. I do need to clean this area here, so I'm gonna press Escape to make sure I unselect the current tool and create a new healing brush tool right here. So I'm gonna select this area, turn off the overlay, and I'm going to clean this up right here. And let's see where Lightroom selected. That's a bad area, so I'll move right here. Select this area. Looks better. Turn off the overlay. Go to Content Aware. Whoops, got to undo that. I have to press Escape to make sure I don't change the tools while it's selected. Now I'm going to clean this up a little bit. So scroll over this or brush over this. And yeah, so that looks a lot better. You can see a little bit of the duplicate of the snow patch here and on here. So to get rid of that, I'll clean that up and I'll clean that up a little bit. So I'm gonna zoom out and see how the image looks before and after. So it looks a lot better with the person or the couple removed, but I noticed one transition area right here. It's still not that good, so let me see what I can do here. I can go to the clone tool and I can brush over here. That looks a little bit good. See what happens when the feather or the transition I decrease to zero. Looks horrible, so I'll keep it at 100. Turn on the overlay and I'm going to move this around a little bit. Okay. Let me see here. I'm going to decrease the feather on this and just correct this area right here. And right here. Increase the feather. Or no, decrease it. Let's see how it looks. Get on the overlay again. And then select this. Now let's see the before and after. Turn off the overlay. So that definitely looks a lot better. Let me zoom out of here. So yeah, this image looks pretty good, and I'm just going to clean it up a little bit more. Get rid of this person right here. So I'll start with the crop tool. Crop it. Get it here. And get it here. Press enter. And then I'm going to go to transform. Actually, I'll go to lens correction first. Enable lens correction. I took this photo with an iPhone 12 Pro. Turn that off. Go to transform. And I'm going to change the The vertical, no, I'll change the horizontal aspect. See how it looks. And I'll rotate it a little bit. And you can see this white area here, so I'll make sure to constrain crop. And let me see here, let me take a look at the aspect, no. Yeah, so that looks pretty good right here. Actually, I'll rotate it a little bit more to level it out. And now I'm gonna go to the basic tool or the basic panel. So it's got the Apple Pro profile, which is from my phone or the photo, the DNG file. Anyways, I'm going to increase the texture a bit, the clarity, make it pop a little bit more, add more color, a little bit of saturation. The vibrance will put more color to the unsaturated areas, whereas saturation will affect the saturation of the whole image. And one thing I forgot to do is correct the white balance. So I'll click on this tool, select an area that should be totally black, see how it looks. It's too warm for me, so I'll close it out or decrease it and make it a little bit cooler. Now I'm gonna go to the tone curve. I'm gonna increase the midtones, make it look a little bit brighter. And now I'm gonna go to the effects and decrease or darken the vignette. And I'll increase the feather a bit. That looks good. So there you go. This is the before, and this is the after image. And hopefully you guys know how to remove people or an object in an image, as well as clean up any of the back or background artifacts that may mess up your image after you remove a person. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to subscribe, give it a like, and follow me on Instagram. Have a good one.